sometimes it's very important for people to understand more about the dance instead of just doing it the whole time. I started dancing 14 years ago. My mom is a singer and my dad is a bass player, so for me it was normal to dance. The first battle I did, Nyako was there, was at my first battle, and everyone laughed at me. But because I had a dream, an idea and a vision, I was able to overcome all that laughing and the way people looked at me back then. I found a way to grow faster, to be able to understand the dance in such a way that I could really grow smart, basically. I used to do martial arts, and I used to really love art, drawing, stuff like that. So what I did was I took the ideas of martial arts and stuff like that, and I put it into my dance. I created philosophies, ideas of the dance, and that helped me to understand it better, and that way I was able to grow really fast. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give you a few of these ideas, and hopefully with that, you're gonna understand the dance a little bit better and grow faster just like me. So let's see. The first thing I ever learned in dance was called build up by breaking off. So what I did was I took my dance and I saw it as a big wall. And I broke it off to understand every piece separate. And because I understand every piece separate, I'm able to create and make my own dance. Basically, it's like words. Dance is a language, right? Somehow we tend to always learn the words, but we forgot to learn the letters. This is a word, because it's a basic, it's a word. But if we want to create our own dance, we have to break that off too and try to understand the letters to be able to talk ourselves. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna give you the letters of groove in hip hop. And with these letters, if you take them separate and you bring them back, you can create your own words, your own sentences, you can create your own dance. Everything is very basic, but a wall or a building is not built off of one block. You have to have the pieces separate, you have to have the foundation, and then build that up. Let's start. And my friend basically told me, Kev, stop it, here you go. Or stand here, stand straight. All you do is just move your head, your shoulders, your chest, nothing more. And then for like 5 hours I would be sleeping. What I learned from this is very important. Everyone has his own style, right? Everyone has his own little dance style. Dance styles used to be created like this. I do this dance, but I cannot do this with that. So dance styles were limited. For instance, this is what happens when somebody has a style. I'm very good with my chest, but I'm very bad with my feet. So my style is gonna be based on my chest. So then you get someone that's like this the whole time. Problem is, people think that's a style, but some way, to be honest, it's a limit. I believe if we really want to create our own style, we have to be able to use everything we have and then choose whatever we like to use. Okay, let's see. Yeah, so when you did this exercise, there's probably a few parts that feel really, really strange. For instance, a lot of people when they dance with their hips, they're like, it feels really weird. And most of the people with the chest works the best. The head is kind of, the sides are kind of hard, right? These. So basically, I just gave you a very easy way to become better. All you have to do is find what part works the best and what part works the worst, and you just change them up and make your worst your best. groove separation. You have two ways of groove. Yeah, two. You have separate body groove. That means I separate what I'm doing into six parts. It's a separate groove because I only use my head. Boom. Oh, and you have full body groove. That means I use my full body. I'm gonna give you the full body groove. It has three aspects. These are the three basics of hip hop groove. And when I mean basics, I mean the word. No, the letters. If you put full body groove and separate body groove together, you can create your own little dance steps. Now, you should not be able to do the same groove the whole time, actually. Why? With the groove separation, you have 50 different ways to do one step. You have so much possibilities right now, because if you add a bounce and one separation, you get a new step. If you add a groove and one separation, you add a new step. If I do this, and keep this rotating here, I have a new step. If I do this and do the bounce with it, I have a new step. I can create whatever I want. The trick is to be able to use every part, bounce, groove, rock, head, shoulder, chest, hips, la la la, and be able to freestyle completely with one part. And then you know you're able to do everything with it and you master it. In hip hop, somehow, I don't know where, people started doing the same groove to every song, in every competition or whatever, everywhere. I don't know why, where it comes from. Ever seen Link do just this? I don't see him do it. I see him do this. And then, maybe, I see him do this. But I never see him do a full round of that. So, we're gonna change that up. We're gonna do six different ways to do one step. Six different ways so that you'll never, ever, ever be able to just do that. Okay? When I started dancing again, I was talking about my start. The same friend who taught me this, the separation, did this funny thing with me. He took me to my house and put me in the middle of my room. I had these towels in the floor and he put me into the towels. They're like, no. Come here. There you go. Stand in the towels.
Okay.
Stop. No. All you do is you take the stupid ass towels and you just step. I took these towels and it helped me develop my footwork. I learned about every direction. I learned about front, back, side, back, cross, front, cross. I was able to not only move front and side, I was able to use it here, there, side, back, side. And that way, this stupid ass exercise helped me to unlock my legs. Six ways to do one step. The pattern is really basic. All I do is this. I step front, I step back, I step side, I cross, boom, 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 cross front, boom, 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 boom. That's the pattern. Now I'm gonna give different steps inside that little pattern with the music. We did something very basic. But this basic idea makes you really understand yourself as a dancer. You understand what you're good at, you understand what is not that good, you understand what you like, you understand what you don't really like. And that way you can create your own style because you have all the little words. So if we combine this, you get a complete hip-hop groove thing. If I combine separate body, full body, boom, and the steps. Ta-da! You get hip-hop. Okay, basically this is my easiest way to become better. Simple as that. I always trained to three different types of music. Soulful, raw hip-hop, and electronic. To be able to dance to everything, I just created three styles for myself, three characters. So I'm gonna give these three to you. The idea is now that I just give you mine, but in the end, you have to create your own. The first style works like this. It's called the gentleman. You have to think that you have a beautiful suit, tie, suitcase, tie up, and you have to dance like a gentleman or a gentlewoman. For me, I dance very up, boom, 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 boom. Very like this, very clean. Try to be creative. So if you're a gentleman or a gentlewoman, do you have a nice car? You have a beautiful suitcase. What is inside the suitcase? Maybe you have a big ass wallet or whatever with some money.
Girl, I know this might seem strange, but let me know if I'm out of order for stepping to you this way. See, I've been watching you for a while, and I just gotta let you know that I'm really feeling your style, 'cause I had to.
So, we were the gentleman, gentlewoman. What's gonna happen is this. You're gonna lose all your money. You're gonna live on the street. You're gonna wear the clothes of your big ass uncle. You know, more rough.
Street style.
Rugged. It's gonna be very ugly. No guns.
Even a Jeep or van, goddamn, we're getting ours, yo. Take a trip up the strip and be like stars, so it doesn't matter if the cops be scoping. They can't do jack, that's why a young brother's open to do anything, anywhere, any place. Buck wild in another court case, it's the code of the streets.
Now what happens is this. This professor comes to you, tells you, you know what? I can give you eternal life. What we're gonna do is this. We're gonna take your heart and replace it with metal. Basically, they create a robot from you. So now you go through life not as a slum, whatever, not as a gentleman, but as a robot. My robot is different from the popping robot. It's not that, no. What I try to do is I try to isolate my groove, or animate my groove, that's the right word. So instead of dancing like this, la, 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 I dance like this. The thing is, they have to create it themselves, so they don't have to take mine. Just like when I do rugged, for instance, my thing with rugged is that I always have my feet like this, boom. I always kick like that, but I didn't tell them that because they have to create their own way of doing it. Think square. Triangle, circle, yeah? I'm gonna tell you something crazy. I use a lot of different things from outside of my dance to let my dance be inspired. When I was doing this, remember? Boom, 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 that stuff. You know, that actually came from that. What you do is this, groove separation, but then triangle, circle, or square. Think of line stops and slow motion. Stops. Slow motion. When I started dancing, I came up with these three because I thought, okay, how can I make my dance interesting? How can I stop doing the same thing, but without too much information and stuff like that? Because basically, you have three different ways of dancing now. Most people only have one. And most of the best, mostly have more. Tight eyes, you know tight eyes?
Yes.
He has five, or maybe six now, but he used to have five different styles. The twins?
Yeah.
If I'm right, they have five too. Five different styles. Kepto?
Yeah.
He never told me his styles, but when I look at his dance, I see one, two, three, and just legs, four. Everyone has more styles, and that way they can easily switch, and because they switch in styles, their dance stays interesting. This is what we're gonna do. All three styles together. You mix them yourself, and then you're gonna see that you have a lot of information in your dance with just a really easy mind game. What I want you to get from this class is very important. Dance always works through a certain line in your body, or actually music does. To be a dancer means to be able to connect your mind and your heart together. This is how it works. When we have the music comes into our ear. First, we have to process it here. To then understand the music to bring it to there. Here we create the feeling that we get from the music. The feeling first goes back to here. And then this has to translate the feeling of the music into here. That's why it's so important to have both. Because if one is missing, or this or that, you're gonna either dance like this or dance like this. But we have to try to get both to really be able to translate the music. Music is creation. Everything in this world has a rhythm. Everything. The sun and the moon, they have a certain rhythm. The way the earth rotates has a rhythm. The way we wake up and go back to bed, the way we eat, the way we, our heart beats, the way we walk, everything has a rhythm. That's what this world is, this universe is created of, rhythms and actually music. A big problem in the world right now is that a lot of people either only are here or are here. This creates war. I need money. I need women. I need to look good. I need nice clothes. I need this, that. How do I become smart? How do I get more money? I need high grades, blah, 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 blah. All here, even better. even battles. What is a battle right now? A battle is this. You, me, who becomes better? Win, lose, money, are the people gonna scream for me? Do they like my moves or do they not like them? And what happens is this. There becomes, you know yin yang? Splits, boom, boom. You have people, battles, just battles, battles, battles. And you have people, ciphers. Just ciphers, 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 this, which is good. But to have the perfect rhythm, we need to have them both together. And I believe that dance is the only place where we are safe to be able to be ourselves and be complete. Because right now, in the world, everything is war. Everything is war, everywhere. And the only way we are gonna stay complete human and be able to be with ourselves and be with everyone is to stay in our comfort zone, stay with the dancers, where everyone understands this and this together. And we have a sort of holy language that only we understand and can talk to each other, and that's dance. To me, that's really important. Really, because in the end, whatever battle, whatever cipher, whatever, whatever, how can I be myself and how can I be with you together?